Good morning. Now we will start discussion on a new module, design of anaerobic digester. In this module, we will discuss basically on the sizing of anaerobic digester. For this purpose, we need some background information, particularly what type of substrates we have, the availability of the substrate, type of substrates, and the ambient conditions, the location where we are going to set up the anaerobic digester, what is the average temperature there. So, all those things are required to decide a particular size to handle certain amount of feedstocks or to produce certain volume of biogas through this anaerobic digestion unit. So, we will discussion on this in this module on the sizing of the anaerobic digestion unit or the anaerobic digester. So, now at first we will see the simple schematic diagram of a biogas plant. So, here waste feedstocks gets entered into first reactor, then secondary reactor, then biomass for fertilizations and biogas for storage. And the factors which influence the plant performance are solid content in the feedstock and then C by N ratio, temperature, pH and retention time. Now, we will see the different feedstocks have different solid content, different biomass potential. So, which reactor is designed to handle wheat straws that cannot handle the same amount of dried leaves, because their biogas potential is different. So, these are some other types of wastes which are having different biogas potential, and temperature also plays a significant role for the biogas productions. Higher the temperature, more the gas formation. Here you see different types of waste has been considered, different temperatures, the 35, 25 and 8 degree centigrade has been considered. So, we see here in all the cases 35 degree is giving us the higher rate of gas production. So, we will be considering the mesophilic zone, that is 35, 38 degree centigrade, and after considering a specific conditions, we will find out the sizing of the reactor. Now, we will see the C by N ratio. C by N ratio is very, very important because it provides the nitrogen for the growth of microorganisms. If N is very less, we have to supplement nitrogen from some other chemicals like some nutrients. So, here some C by N ratio is provided for different types of feedstocks like say rice straw, wheat straw, corn stalks, fallen leaves, wild grass and fresh cattle dung, fresh pig manure and fresh human wastes. So, this is the actually the carbon and N percentage by percent 42 and 0.50, that is converted in terms of 67:1, similarly for these others. And on the basis of literature or background information, so solid content is around 8%. This is for conventional practice. C by N ratio 20:30:1, temperature 25:35, and pH 6.8:7.2, retention time 60-90 days, and for mesophilic digestion it is more than 20 days. So, these are the conditions which we have got from the literature or background information. On the basis of background information, under a certain conditions to handle certain amount of waste or to we will be discussing how to get the size of the anaerobic digestion unit. So, for this purpose let us see first the cross section of a digester. So, this is the cross section of a digester. If we take the cross section of a digester when it is under operation, then we will get different zones inside it. So, this is SL, that is VSL is sludge layer volume, then VD is that active digestion volume, and VGST is your gas storage volume, and VCOL is gas collection volume. So, gas collection volume, gas storage volume, and active digestion volume, and sludge volume. These four volumes we will be getting in the whole reactors. So, four zones we will get. So, what will the total volume? So, total volume is equal to V collection plus VGST plus VD plus VSL. So, this is when it is under operations, in process, this type of phenomena will get inside it, or zones will get inside it. But if we think about the reactor dimensions, our objective is to get the dimension of the reactor and volume of the reactor. So, in this case, this is the say reactor, the dimension is we are getting three different parts. So, this part is having V3 volume, the V1 is top part, V2 is bottom part, and V3 is the volume of the cylindrical part. So, cylindrical portions, top and bottom head, these are the total volume of the reactor, V1 plus V2 plus V3. And here also there is some H1, height of the top head, height of the bottom head, and capital H is the height of the cylindrical portion. And this top head and bottom head may be of different types, it may be hemispherical, it may be torispherical, or many other forms. So, depending upon these two heads may be of similar type or may be of different types also, and all the heads will be having some characteristics diameter, like say R1 is the characteristic diameter of the top head and R2 is the characteristic diameter of the bottom head, and R is the radius of the cylindrical portions and D is the diameter of the cylindrical portions. H1 is the surface area of the top head and H2 is the surface area of the bottom head. So, this is different parameter through which we can explain the geometry of this anaerobic digestion unit. Now, all this V1, V2, S1, S2, V3, R1, R2, H, small h1, small h2, R, D, R, etcetera, all can be expressed in terms of D if we know the type of heads present here. So, depending upon the head type, the expressions will be different, but we can correlate all those terms with R. So, here some example, I will show how to correlate these things. Before that, what is the basic difference between the dimension and the cross section? If we take the cross section, we will get four parts: gas collection, gas storage, active digestion, sludge. But here V1, V2, V3, but this is starting from the top of this cylindrical part, only this is your V1, but here VGST is not from this, from the top of the cylindrical part, some gas will be always stored and the liquid will be going out from this. So, not from the junction of this, that is cylindrical part and top head, not from this, it will be having some below this part, so that is called H1. So, we have to calculate what is the H1 value. So, now VGST, V collection, VD, VSL will try to find out, and also we will try to find out the V1, V2, V3, H, H1, S1, R, etcetera. This is an example which I have collected from this source, that under these conditions, the type of head, the D, the V, D and V is related with this, other parameters like V1, V2, H1, H2, R1, R2, all those things S1, S2 are related with D by different expressions. So, these are the different expressions, these expressions are responsible for the head type reported here, but these will be different if the head types are changed. And these are some thumb rules are there, that we are considering volume of gas collection is less than equal to 5% of the total volume. We are considering volume of sludge that is less than equal to 15% of total volume. We are also considering that volume of gas storage plus volume of active digestion zone is 80% of the total volume of the reactor. And we also assuming that VGST is equal to 0.5 into VGST plus VD plus VSL, that means gas storage volume, active digestion volume, sludge volume into 0.5, that means 50% of that into K. What is K? K is the gas production rate per meter cube digester volume per day. So, if we get the production rate meter cube digester volume per day, so then multiply this with this and 0.5, we will get the VGST, one thumb rule. Another rule is that 50% of total solids, that is 0.5 into Ts into m. What is m? M is the gas production rate per kg of Ts per day. So, per day how much Ts we are adding and how much gas can be produced per unit gram or kg of Ts, that is m, if we multiply it with and multiply it with 0.5, that will also give us VGST. There is another way of thinking. So, this all are our thumb rules or assumptions we can say. So, what will be the value of K and M? That will depend upon the substrate type and also the properties of the substrate, the parameters or the characteristics of those substrate. For Bangladesh, this K value is 0.4 meter cube per meter cube per day and M value is 0.2 meter cube per kg per day. That is basically for cattle dung or cow dung. Now, we will try to calculate the volume of the digester system or anaerobic digestion systems under these conditions. What is the condition? That you have to determine the volume of the digester chamber and dimension of the chamber for the biogas production from the cow dung of 10 cows having body weight of 200 kg each. Assume the temperature is 30 degree centigrade, the solid content of the cow dung is 16%, HRT is 40 days, one cow produces 10 kg cow dung daily. So, this is the conditions. Under these conditions, under these feedstocks availability, we have to design the anaerobic digestion unit and the sizing it. So, what is the total discharge? How many? We have 10 cows and how many? One cow produces 10 kg cow dung daily. So, total discharge or cow dung produced per day is equal to 10 into 10, that is equal to 100 kg per day. Then what is the Ts of the fresh discharge? That is, we are having that 16%. So, out of this 100 kg, we will be having Ts is equal to 100 into 0.16 or 16 kg. Our objective is to, we have to make it 8% in terms of Ts. So, here 8 kg solid is available in 100 kg influent, that is our requirement. Now, 1 kg solid will be 100 divided by 8 kg influent. So, 16 kg solids will be available in 2000 kg influent. So, this 16 kg solid is present in 100 kg of cow dung or discharge. So, we have to make this volume to 200 kg so that it will be of 8% in terms of Ts content. So, what will be the influent? That is 200 kg. So, what will be the water addition? That is 200 minus 100 kg. 100 kg is the cow dung. So, 100 will be the water addition. So, working volume of the digester, we will be assuming working volume is equal to obviously the gas storage zone plus Vd, that is active zone. So, VGST plus Vd equal to Q into HRT. What does it mean? We have that 40 days HRT. That means hydraulic retention time is 40 days. So, if we have the digester, we will be putting the feedstocks for 40 days, then only we will get the discharge from it. So, after 40 days we will get the sludge out. So, retention time is this one. So, the material which is coming out, that is VGST plus Vd, that will be Q into HRT. So, that is equal to, what is this Q? 200 kg per day into 40 day. So, 40 into 200, 8000 kg we are getting. So, 8000 kg in terms of volume, it will be 8 meter cube. If we assume that 1000 kg is equal to 1 meter cube, that is our assumption. So, that will be 8 meter cube. So, for geometrical assumptions, so VGST plus Vd, we have assumed VGST plus Vd, we have assumed that this is 0.80 of the total volume, 80% of the total volume. So, V plus, we have getting this one 8 meter cube. So, V is equal to 8 divided by 0.8 or 10 meter cube. So, 10 meter cube is the volume of the anaerobic digestion unit. So, what will be the D then? So, D is equal to, we have got here D is equal to 1.3078 into V to the power 1/3. So, we will put the value of V here as equal to 10. We will put the value of V equal to 10 here and we will get the value of D, that is equal to 2.8176 meter or around to 2.82 meter. So, next we are having say V1, V2, V3. What is the V3? This V3 equal to pi r square h. So, pi into d square by 4, pi into d square by 4. So, this equal to, and then d equal to how much? We have got d is equal to 2.82 meter. So, if we put the value of d here, d cube, then this V3 is coming 7.046 meter cube. And again V3 we have got from these expressions, V3 is equal to 0.13142 d cube, and we are getting V3 here, this one. So, this and these are equal. So, this and this are equal, and if we equalize this, then we can get the value of h. So, capital H value we are getting from 1.129. So, this h equal to 1.129 meter. Now, h1, what will be the h1, what will be the h2? Once we have got the value of d, we can get the value of h1, because h1 is equal to d by 5 and h2 is equal to d by 8. So, we are getting the 0.564 meter and h2 equal to 0.352 meter. And what will the characteristic radius r1 and r2? r1 is equal to 1.0625 d, that is equal to 2.996 meter, and this is r2, and r1 equal to 0.725 d, that is equal to 2.045 meter. So, then what is v1 and v2? V1 and V2, we have V1 and V2 0.827 d cube and 0.5011 d cube. So, we have got the value of d. So, we will get the value of V1 here, 1.855 meter cube. So, this one, and this is equal to V2 equal to 1.124 meter cube. So, now all the dimensions we are able to calculate now. Now, we will see B collection is equal to maximum say 5% we are assuming of V. So, 0.05 V equal to 0.5 meter cube, and V GST is equal to 0.5 into V GST plus V D plus V SL into K, that is equal to 0.5 into what is this V GST, V D and V SL. This is equal to total V minus V COL. So, that is equal to V minus COL into K, or 0.5 into 10 minus 0.5. So, 9.5, we are getting 0.5 into 9.5 into 0.4, 1.9 meter cube. So, that is VGST is equal to 1.9 meter cube we are getting. Now, we are VGST, that is another thumb rule we have taken another consideration, that VGST is 50% of daily gas yield, that is 0.5 into TS into gas production rate per kg TS per day. So, here also we will put the values. So, 0.5 into 100 into 0.16, the total solid present in it, and then 0.28 is the M values. So, we are getting 2.24 meter cube. So, one assumption is giving us 1.9 meter cube volume requirement, another assumption is giving us 2.24 meter cube volume requirement for the digestion unit. So, to be conservative, we will be considering 2.24 meter cube. So, 2.24 meter cube is our VGST. So, VGST plus V collection, these two will give us 0.5 plus 2.24, that is 2.74 meter cube. Then V1 is equal to what? If we see this one, what is this V1? Here we have V1, this is our V1, and this is our VGST, and this is our V collection at the top. So, V1 is equal to, we can write VGST plus VGST plus V COL. So, this is our VGST and this is V COL, and this part is our H1. This height is equal to H1, VGST plus VCL, VCOL minus this cylindrical part. So, pi d square by 4 into H1. So, this is the expressions we are getting here. So, this one. So, minus pi d square H1 by 4. So, we will put this value here, that is 2.74 minus 6.24 into H1, this value we are getting. So, by rearranging, H1 is coming, what is V1? V1 is equal to 1.855, V1 is equal to 1.855. So, if you will put the values there, and then H1 is coming 0.142. So, assuming VSL is equal to 15%, so V equal to this 15% of V, then 10 into 0.15, that is equal to 1.5 meter cube. So, now we have got the different dimensions, and then what is VD? VD equal to V minus V GST minus V collection minus V SL. So, we have got the value of V 10 and V GST equal to 2.74, V COL equal to 1.5 and VSL equal to 1.5 and V COL equal to 0.5. So, V GST plus CL both are 2.74. So, ultimately we are getting VD equal to 5.76 meter cube. So, this way we are able to calculate all the dimensions, all the volumes, that is here VD, VGST, V collections and VSL in terms of the dimensions of this anaerobic digestion unit. So, this is all about the sizing of the anaerobic digestion unit we have discussed in this module. Thank you very much for your patience.